Hi guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to filter with wildcards. Now here I have a normal query which selects the forename, surname and nationality from my table drivers. That is the database containing all Formula One driver, all Formula One data, and what I'm selecting here is those three fields from the table drivers. Now before I proceed, I'm going to use a different program to access my SQLite database because I see that this content here, or this text, is not very readable in a YouTube video, especially if you're watching this video on a mobile device. So what I did, I am using Visual Studio Code for coding. It's a bit more than a text editor. It's actually a programming IDE, integrated development environment. And what I did, I added an extension called SQLite, which allows me to access the database from Visual Studio Code, because here I can zoom the text, make the text bigger here to render it much more readable than, you know, basically playing around in the SQLite database. And there's the same query I had before, select forename, surname, nationality from drivers, and there's the data. Now, if we start filtering, let's do a normal filter, an exact filter. If I know exactly what I want, let's say I need all drivers whose forename is Nico. So I go like where, and then forename equal to Nico, and save it, and then I just run the query, and I get these two guys. Right, now that is okay if I know exactly what I want, but often it's like this that you don't know what you want. You have a certain pattern that you're looking for, but you don't know exactly what you want. For instance, I'm looking for all drivers whose forename is or ends with O. So now I need to have all drivers whose forename ends with O. There's no way I can work with this, because if I work with this type of query, then I would have to, you know, append a lot of ors, and then forename is equal to whatever the next name with O is, and so on. There's no way I could possibly run such a query. So here, what I need is some sort of wildcard. And in SQL, you have two wildcards. One is the percent, and that is a wildcard for, infinite number of characters. So for instance, if I'm looking for all forenames ending with O, so basically the name at the beginning, I don't care about it, I don't know. So that's where that wildcard comes in. That's a wildcard for infinite number of characters. All I know is that the name has to end with O. So the last character of the name or of the forename is an O. And that's the way the filter would be. So basically, the final character of the forename is O. Before that, couldn't care less. So that's why I have this wildcard, for whatever characters are before the O. Important is that the O is the final character. And then, before I run that, another thing is that when using wildcards in your query, you can't use an equal. You have to use the word like. Now what that means, that we're not looking, because if you keep the equal, what that means, you're looking for somebody called percent O. You're never going to find anybody like this. So to make SQL clear that this is a wildcard, you have to use the word like. So now what SQL does, it searches for all names that end, or forenames rather, that end with O. Let's save that and let me run that query. And there you go. So now I have all forenames that end with O. So, and there's no way I could get these with a normal exact query, because then I would have like a lot of ors, like forename is equal to Ukuyu, forename, or forename is equal to Vincenzo, or forename is equal to Norberto, and so on. So with a wildcard, you just have it here like this. Now that's the first wildcard we have, which is basically a wildcard for, you know, unlimited number of characters. And that's here, that's very helpful here, because I don't actually care how long each forename is, as long as it ends with an O. What if I want all forenames that begin with, all forenames that end with an O, but are only four letters long? Now, or four characters long. Now, how do I do that? So here, I need the second placeholder, wildcard, which is the underscore. An underscore is a wildcard or a placeholder for just one character. And here, the requirement is find all names that end with O, but are four characters long. So I know the last character, that's O, but the first three characters of the four character name, I don't know. So I just put three wildcards, each denoting just one of those unknown characters. And the final one, I know that one, so I have an O here. So now with this query, unlike the previous one, I'm getting all four names ending with O, but they're also four letters or four characters long. Just let me save that, run that query. And there you go. Now I have all O ending forenames, but those only with, that are four characters long. And you can obviously combine multiple wildcard filters just the way you would do with just normal filters. So for instance, I can say, and forename, like. In this case, I'm seeking for all forenames beginning with A, but are four characters long. So 1, 2, 3. So now, in this case, this query is basically has two filters. One, seeking for all four character forenames that end with O, or those forenames which begin with A, but are also four characters long. Save that, run that query. And, or let me do five characters. So I'd have to add another placeholder. So now I'd have like 4 and 5, and let's run that query. And there you go. So now I have those names, either they fulfill this first condition, which is basically ending with O and four characters long, like Liko and Timo, or they begin with A, but are five characters long. That's why I needed four placeholders or wildcards for those additional four characters in addition to that A. So that's why we get like Alan, Aguri, Alain, and so on. Okay, so that's how you can work with those patterns or those wildcards. And obviously you can combine multiple wildcards in one like statement. For instance, let's say if I'm searching for a surname which has O as its second character. Yeah, all surnames which have O as their second character. In this case, let me take this one off. I know the first character of the name, I don't know. So that gets a placeholder for one character, the underscore. The second letter, I know it's an O. Okay, oops, an O. That's pretty clear. And beyond that, I don't know, don't care. So I just put the placeholder for infinite number of letters. And this would get me all surnames as well. I have to fix the field surname. So now what this does, it gets me all surnames that have O as a second letter. And if I save that, if I save that and run the query, then I would have all surnames which have O as a second letter. So that's the way you combine those wildcards together within one filter or one like statement.